Haley, how are you, girl?
I'm good, sister. How are you?
Doing great. Hey, we have a special guest tonight.
Oh, I heard. Yeah, I heard. I'm very excited.
Me too. She's coming in to talk about a big conference coming up. Mm-hmm. So let's see if we can get her to come out of the closet.
What do you think?
Linda!
Hi!
Hi! Come on in!
Come on in, girl. Good to see you.
How you doing?
Excellent.
Oh, I'm so glad to have you here today.
Hi.
Oh, dear. You're such a sweetie for coming on. And by the way, you're officially the first person to come out of our closet.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Whenever we have a guest, they'll be coming out of the closet.
Yeah.
Not literally. Not everybody is coming out of the closet, but they'll be coming out of that closet. Not out of the closet.
She's straight. It's okay.
So, Linda, you joined us tonight so we can talk about an up-and-coming conference, I understand.
Yes, I am. Here to talk to you about the conference that two other women and myself put together 9 years ago. This will be our ninth year, called This Could Never Happen to Me.
Oh. Tell us more.
Okay. What it involves is three women got together about 9 years ago and wanted to inform other women of the risks of being HIV positive.
Okay.
And having unprotected sex, and because everything that was out there was geared for men, and women were being infected and nothing was being done for them. So we decided to get together with the help of my boss from Good and Best Community Health Center, and we put a team together and we started the conference called This Could Never Happen to Me.
Wow. And if I understand correctly, this conference is for women, by women, about women.
Yes.
So, no men.
No men out of the bed.
Even if I go there looking like this.
Sorry, sister.
Oh, well.
She's always trying to crash somebody's party.
Oh, you know, girl. This year it's at the Century House, right?
Yep, it's at the Century House. Like I said, it started 9 years ago. We started at the zoo.
Oh,
it was our first conference. And there was only 45 people that showed up, 45 women.
Well, still, that's a good turnout for the first time.
Yeah, for the first time. Especially informational.
Next year, we had it the same spot. And it was a little bit more, and we outgrew there, and we went to the Whaling City. The real pretty place on.
Oh, Wamsutta Club. Yes,
Club.
That's a beautiful venue for anything in the city.
And we was there for a few years, and then we outgrew there, and we end up at the Century House. So this is going to be our third year at the Century House, and last year we had over 200 women.
Oh, excellent.
Wow.
Excellent. Now, how does the Century House treat you guys with the when it's time for your
event?
Oh,
they're really, really excellent with us. They open us, up with, try to accommodate us any way possible.
Well, that's excellent.
We have like a little book that we put together, and they usually buy an ad.
Excellent.
To advertise to kind of give back. But like I said, the conference is something that, we have no funding. No one funds us for it. We send letters. We ask
all private donations.
Private donations, and that's how we raise the money for.
Wow!
Excellent.
That's wonderful. And this year, you're expecting more women.
Yes. Well, as of last Thursday. Yeah, as of last Thursday, I already had 95 women signed up.
Wow!
That's phenomenal. And I actually have a friend from the Brockton area who is planning to come down with some people from there. So hopefully you guys will hit a 100, 125 mark.
Hopefully even more than that.
Yes.
Yeah, me too.
Yes.
I do too. I'll do what I can.
We'll have, like I said, it's a full day conference. We serve breakfast. We serve lunch. We have a motivational speaker. We have a doctor that'll be on speaking. This year our theme is breaking the chains, which is a lot of women over the years we usually ask, what they liked about the conference, what they would like to see.
Right.
And a lot of the questions were to do with drug-related and HIV. So this year our conference is geared to drug addiction and HIV and the effects of what drug addiction has on someone who's HIV positive. I also have a panel of three women that will be speaking. One woman is an ex-addict.
Mm-hmm.
she's in recovery. Another woman is a mother of an adopted child that has the virus. And the third person is one of our kids who was born HIV positive.
Prenatally infected.
Prenatally infected.
And at what age is that? Well, it'd have to be a she because she's in this conference.
Right.
How old is she?
She is 19 years old.
Wow.
Wow.
Excellent.
And she's doing
excellent.
Well?
Excellent.
So
work,
happy to hear that.
She's working, you know, she's living with family. She lost both her parents, mm-hmm. unfortunately. Mm. But she's amazing. She's, you know, to look at her and remember back in the day, her mother and I and another friend, we were all good friends and we did everything together, went everywhere together. And to think that doctors told us these kids wouldn't live past the age of 3.
Right. Well, at that time, they didn't really have
yes.
much information.
And right now, our oldest baby, who is a boy, just turned 18 September 11th.
Excellent.
Wow.
And our oldest is going on 23.
Oh.
So.
Wow.
Bless them.
Now, that's the kids, when you say our kids, they're part of a group called Mass Care?
Well, it used to be Mass Care. And it was ran out of the Great Macbeth Community Health mm-hmm. Center, where we had a clinic, and the doctors from Boston would come down once a month, and they would, you know, follow these, you know,
right.
children or mothers who were carrying their babies. They would follow them and, you know, do all the protocols, work with the doctors, so to ensure that that baby was born
right.
Without the virus in them. So, and then we lost that grant. Funding was cut for that grant, and we lost it at the health center, and about 3 years now. And every time I got to speak to someone in Boston, I was like, you know, my kids, you know,
unbelievable.
I just worried about them all,
right.
all the time. And it just so happened that the grant was up for bids again, and Don Fukuda from the Department of Public Health told my boss, Paul Cassidy, and I that it was becoming available and that we should apply.
Mm-hmm.
And we did. And we got the grant.
Oh, excellent. Congratulations. Excellent. I love to hear that happy story like that.
We have it back. Dr. Mao is going to be coming back to the health center. They're trying to get all the paperwork
wow,
together.
She's wonderful.
So we wonderful, will have
wonderful
her back
doctor.
Here and Kathy Canute, and they will do the clinic. The kids are excited. They're ecstatic
because
that's the doctor that they've known since.
Right.
You know, she's been in the field many, many years.
Right, since they were a baby. And now that they're all grown, they're all struggling, you know, because they had to go from her to an adult doctor,
mm-hmm.
which is a big, you know, transition. So they're all really excited now that she's coming back, you know, and even the ones that have established themselves with one of the doctors that we have on staff, they're all planning on going back
to her. Of course,
of course.
Now, I know I brought us off the subject of the conference, and it's all good information, and I'm really happy to hear this. This is wonderful news.
Mm-hmm.
But going back to the conference, so you have a panel. You've got the three
panel.
Individuals who'll be talking. You have some medical advisors.
And medical advisors to be speaking. We have a motivational speaker that will be speaking. And then, of course, we have our three panel speakers. We have, we do what is called a Chinese auction,
mm-hmm.
where we have people that have volunteered gift certificates and made gifts and stuff like that. And every woman that comes will find, if we have 12 gifts, you'll have 12 tickets inside your
mm-hmm.
envelope to put wherever you
wonderful.
Want to go. And, you know, you'll be able to walk away along with all of the information from the different drug reps
right.
and things that'll be there. They'll walk away with something. And then we all make our own centerpieces. And usually what we do is we'll raffle it off or we'll put numbers into the chair and they can take, you know, the
mm-hmm.
raffle. There will be testing on site.
Excellent.
Good.
Excellent.
Excellent.
Which we've had in the past few years. And, you know, I believe we have 20... enough for 20 to be tested again this year.
Good.
We've been very lucky so far. No one has ever tested positive,
mm-hmm.
but it's there. It's offered. And it's not a conference where everybody in the room is infected with HIV. And
right.
I want to stress that because some people has asked me that. Well, is it just for? And it's not. It's for women in general.
It's for information.
It's for information to keep yourself safe.
Right.
You know, and to know what is happening, because women are getting infected at a very high rate right now.
They are.
So what that's telling us is somewhere along the line, they're not getting the information.
Or there's not enough out there.
Or there's not enough information out there that they need to protect themselves.
Right.
Because especially women over 50, which is your new highest rate of new infections. You know, you got the year of the cougar.
Mm-hmm.
You know, all the young guys want to go with the older lady.
And, yeah.
You know, and that's okay. But
you're not old enough to be a cougar yet, though.
No.
Yeah, 2 years ago.
So you need to learn how to take care of yourself, because
right.
no one else is going to do that.
That's
for
right.
You.
No,
not
that's absolutely. Right. No, absolutely. There is a certain amount of self responsibility for anybody right. when it comes to HIV and AIDS.
You know,
but
you have women that is 65 years old, newly divorced, is married for 20, 25 years, and now she's testing positive to HIV. That's a problem.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is a problem. Yeah.
That's a problem.
Simply the fact that there's not enough information out there to get to people.
Right.
You know,
it's not only that. It's in nursing homes. You know, they put people with HIV in nursing homes and they just put them there.
Yeah.
You know? They're old. Just because they're old doesn't mean they're not going to go sneaking into each other's bedrooms.
Hey.
Right. Right.
You know, so, you know, you even have it, you have it there, and these, you know, they're just not listening. They're not learning. Well, not even that they're not listening. They just don't have the information
right.
that they need.
Right.
You know, to survive.
Do you think there's something the state can do as far as information getting it out there? I know that they target audiences, mm-hmm. but in my opinion, isn't the day of targeting audience over? Shouldn't we make more of a public statement, period, not keep targeting?
They keep targeting
men,
you know, it's
women,
still,
gay, black, white.
Right.
Why not just put it out there, spend money on mainstream publications, mm-hmm. and say HIV is here,
and it's
still here,
anywhere.
And
right.
unless you know what's going on, it's not going anywhere.
Right.
Right. You know, and that's something that, you know, we have to look back at years ago. When I started in this field 20 years ago, there was nobody. Women that I knew, anyways, that were infected. Everything I know, everything I learned,
mm-hmm.
I learned from my gay brothers, because that's all I had
right.
back then. So we used to follow them everywhere they went. We just soaked up all the information and this is why I sit where I sit today,
mm-hmm.
you know, because of them. But what happens is they're all not going to be here anymore.
Right, and not everyone has a gay brother.
And not everybody, right.
Right.
You know, not everybody has the love of their gay brothers like I did,
mm-hmm.
you know. I mean, I could call any one of them up till today, you know, and say, hey, whatever, you know, and I know that they're right here. And a lot of people don't look at
right.
them like that, you know, it's, you know, the hush-hush or whatever, but... Thank God I've never gone that route. You know, to me, I feel like they're the ones who taught me who I am today.
Right.
You know?
Right.
And without them, I don't know where I would be. And that's the honest truth.
Yeah.
You know, and unfortunately, people today don't have what I had years ago. They don't have the agency that I had to learn from years ago.
Right.
So it's left up to us that are left here to be able to hopefully pass it on to someone else who will carry this forward. Because if it doesn't, then, you know, it's going to become an epidemic like
yes.
it was before.
Yes.
You know, mm-hmm. and part of the reason why everything is so quiet now is people don't act up the way they used
mm-hmm.
to.
You know? Ooh, I don't think act up even acts up like it used to.
No, really.
Those were the days. There was something to say about those days. Being chained to a bridge in Cambridge. You know,
I mean, back in the day, it's like when, you know, the people that you knew that were involved in working with people with AIDS or the agencies or whatever, we were tight knit, you know.
Yeah, they don't act up like they used to. Anybody who was around mm-hmm. 20, 25 years ago, mm-hmm. in even the fringe groups of what we called PWAs, mm-hmm. the people we worked with, the people we knew, the people we helped. The people, the friends of ours
mm-hmm.
who are passing and dying, mm-hmm. those of us remember how political charged it was at the time.
Yes.
Right.
Because truthfully, people were fighting for their lives.
Yep. They didn't know
what was happening
what
next.
What was happening? They didn't know when the next day was. You know, they were, they just wanted to live. And they
Absolutely.
Wanted to live well. You know, if they had 10 days left, they wanted to live right. well them 10 days.
Right.
You know? And it's not like that. You know, people are complaining. A lot of people say, oh, the medicine, you know, let me tell you some of the side effects and stuff on the medicine.
Yeah.
You know, you wouldn't want to take it. You know, and that's something that, you know, once you start taking a med, you got to take it every single day. So every single day you wake up in the morning and you say, if I don't take this pill today, I might die,
mm-hmm.
you know. And people think it's something because I've gone places and I've heard kids say, well, you know, they got pills.
Yeah, you young know, people just don't get it. Like,
they don't. They
especially the younger generation. They really don't understand what the older generation
well,
has gone
many
through.
Many of them haven't buried a friend.
Right.
And when they have...
Well, thank God that they have.
Well, yes, but at the same token, that is made was what made things happen.
Yeah.
Like
right.
this conference.
Right.
It couldn't happen to me. The women got mad. They
right.
wanted
mad
something
they
to
wanted something,
protect themselves.
You know, they wanted to learn. They wanted to know how to protect themselves.
Right.
A lot of... men in general, all of them, you know, they were secretly using or they were secretly seeing other men and, you know, the wives didn't know about it or whatever and they were getting infected
mm-hmm.
and nobody knew what to do with them.
Right.
You know, because they didn't fit in any category.
Oh, absolutely not.
They weren't the drug addict. They weren't the gay man. So where did they go? They hung them there like...
Right,
you know,
in limbo.
Limbo
And it's been still going on in some
still,
cases.
And it's still that way. You know, there's still things that are coming out. Even some of the medications that they've made. They made that medication geared for men. So you take a small, frail woman who's taken the meds that someone, a man weighing 350 pounds is
right,
taking.
Right.
So you can imagine what she's going through. Compared to what, you know, he's going through.
She may definitely have much more side effects to that
right.
medication.
Yes. You know, so, you know, it's not, they just don't put women in the forefront.
No.
And they need to stop.
Well, that's what your
I
conference
agree.
Is really doing.
I agree.
And I think your conference is doing that in a very positive light. When is it?
It's October 25th.
Okay.
At the Century House. Starts registration is at 8:30.
A.M.
A.M. And it's on till 3. And I would just say if anyone wants to come, call Susan Osnow at Greater New Bedford Community Health Center, 508-992-6553. Or you can ask for me, Linda Spinner, same number, 508-992-6553. And we'll put you on a list and, you know, get you registered and come down. And believe me, I've met women... in the streets who remembered that conference from the year before or whatever
mm-hmm.
and said, oh my God, I really want to go again. You know, so it's a wonderful conference with a lot of information geared to help women stay safe.
Now, if someone...
And we also
the...
have massage.
Ooh.
and you sure I can't sneak in?
Now, if the general public wanted to make a donation to your cause, how would they go about doing that?
Just, we have... letters that we do send out to different organizations asking for donations, whether it be money donations or donation of something that, you know, like hairdressers have given us, free haircuts
mm-hmm.
and some gift certificates. And if they wanted to, they could make that donation. And I believe it's still going to A.I.D.S. in care of Jim Catino.
Excellent.
Or they can send it to Greater New Bedford Community Health Center in care of Susan Osnow.
Well, we're going to take that information from you tonight before you leave because we do have Straight Talk with Sister C
mm-hmm.
Facebook page
mm-hmm.
and we have a YouTube page, Straight Talk with Sister C. So we're going to make this absolutely available to anyone. Taylor and I strongly believe
yes.
in supporting the community and this is a very powerful event.
Mm-hmm.
We wish we could be there, but we understand. But we wish you so much luck with this,
yes.
and you've done such a great job.
Thank you.
And we can't be there, but we want to support you. We'll make sure we give you as much advertisement about this as I can. Mm-hmm. Any men out there who want to help, you still can make donations,
right.
raffles. You own a restaurant, send them a gift certificate, please.
Please.
Make a donation. Tell the woman in your life, Mm-hmm. And even if you're gay, I'm sure you have a woman somewhere in your life, you can tell. A coworker, a friend, tell them about the conference.
Sister,
have them come up. Sister, but I can't go, so don't tell me. But please.
And, you know, and even, you know, this year is 9th year. We're already geared
for
next year. The next year is our 10th year, and it's we want it
That's
to
a
be
event.
A really big, big event. You know, because it is a 10-year, and we don't know how much longer we'll be able to get funded for it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So every year we've said, this is it. We're done because we're stressed so much.
Well, we're going to make it to the 10th year.
You know, and there's, you know, it's like there's like 5 women that put this conference together that struggle with trying to get donations and getting letters out. And so anybody that wants to come on the committee to lend a hand, we start right up in January. And all you got to do is call me at the Help Center and we'll be glad to put you on the list because new ideas are good ideas.
Excellent.
Absolutely. Linda, thank you so much for coming out.
Yes.
Oh, you're welcome. Thank you for inviting me.
We'll do it again next year,
always
we
welcome,
promise.
Dear,
and
welcome.
You're always welcome. Whenever you get a project going on, come in and see us.
All right.
Let us know.
Even when you don't, if you want to come chill with us, that's fine.
We'll get a little. Eventually, our set will have a coffee table, some coffee.
Can we get some Dunkin' Donuts in here?
Oh, some snacks. Ooh,
I don't know.
Girl.
If Dunkin' Donuts wants to sponsor the show, we'll get Dunkin'
How about
Donuts
Krispy Kreme? You know, we'd love your sponsorship.
Oh, just peddling our asses for anything we can get. thank you so much, Linda. It has been great having you here. And you do have the support of Straight Talk with Sister and Lady T. We'll be there for
thank
you.
Thank you. Thank you for all
thank
everything
you.
That you guys do.
Anytime.
We try.
To help not only me, but other people that are living with HIV and AIDS on a daily basis.
We'll do our best.
I just want to say thanks.
Thank you.
Anything to try and make their lives easier.
Yep.
And you do.
We try. We'll be back shortly with another guest or some more entertainment.
That's right.